I love the colorful clothes you wear and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair. I hear the sound of a gentle wind on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air.
Well, riding a shortboard, there's a lot more movement as far as on the wave and a lot of tail whips and things like that. Longboarding, I feel like there's a lot more style involved. You're cruising along, you can walk up the board, walk back, still do some sharp turns, just not whip it off the top as easily. Things like hanging 10 and cheater fives are just fun. I think it involves a little more style. I think the culture of the shortboarders are, I would say, probably a little more rowdy and a little more rambunctious. The longboarders are more laid back, low key, kind of take things easy. I think that's the difference.
Longboarders, like long hair and stuff, and like listen to like oldies and that kind of stuff. And then shortboarders, all like punk rock and all that stuff. Aggression. I don't know, maybe sometimes.
Generally, the short board is a more performance board. It's a faster board. It's one that you use to rip up the waves. The long boards is not quite as much performance. There is a performance type board, but it's really basically you're cruising the whole time on the wave. You know, it's not a real fast one. Generally, you know, because of the etiquette, generally it's one wave, one surfer. Generally, the shortboarder is a little more of a hot shot.
Got a lot of sharks out there trying to take a bite of something. It was hot. A lot of chameleons out there trying to change up anytime something new comes along. Everybody wants a bite. Don't happen overnight.
So you want to be a rock superstar and live large, big house, five cars, you're in charge, coming up in the world. Don't trust nobody, gotta look over your shoulder. Remember the days when I was a young kid growing up, looking in the mirror, dreaming about blowing up the rock crowds, make money, chill with the honeys, sign autographs, and whatever the people want from me. Shit's funny how impossible dreams manifest in the games that be coming with it. Nevertheless, you got the gold from the gusto, but you don't know about the blood sweat.
Shortboarders and longboarders.
Shortboarders.
Do you like shortboarding?
Yeah.
No.
That's how we do it, I guess.
Okay, how do you feel about riding a shortboard? Like,
fun.
How do you feel about riding it?
Fun.
Confident.
Confident.
How do you feel about longboarders?
They suck. Cool.
They're stupid. They're annoying. Wave hogs.
What about them? Why are they stupid?
Because they're just old guys who can't surf, so they ride a bigger board.
So they ride their bigger boards and...
They're like this thick.
That it's like cheating, basically.
It's like not even surfing.
How do you feel about little kids, like, swimming out there?
they're like idiots. Run them over, and they're like idiots. They play like swim under the surfboard.
How do you feel about bodyboarders?
They're just as bad as longboarders.
Speed bump.
Speed bump.
Think there's any difference in shortboarding and longboarding?
Big difference, yeah.
Like, what do you think those are?
Shortboarding, since it's a shorter board, it's like a lot faster. You can just go all over the wave on a longboard. It's cool too, but like, you ride down the wave and I don't know, like, it's more of a flow kind of thing when you longboard and it's easier. But like when you shortboard, you're just like all over the place and you're ripping it and you're just like carving like big lines and just like laying back and stuff. It's pretty cool.
Do you think there's any difference in the people that ride the boards, like the different cultures?
Yeah, longboarders are super cool, but I know a lot of shortboarders that are kind of dicks or jerks, but there's a lot of cool shortboarders too, you know? But the shortboarders are more like aggressive, I'd say.
Okay, thank you.
All right,
that's it.
Things never stay the same way they began. I heard that some never get fooled to the fullest. That's why fools end up dining on a bullet. Think everything's fine in the big time.
Yes, I am a shortboarder.
Okay. Have you ever been longboard?
Yes, I have.
So what are the differences you notice between riding shortboard and longboard?
Shortboarding is more fun.
And like what way?
I don't know. You can turn better.
Okay. Do you notice the difference between like the people that ride shortboards and people that ride longboards? Like the stereotype of the general shortboard or longboard?
I don't know.
No love, the pony. Gotta hit the boat solely. So the record gets pushed by Sony. I'm in the middle like Moni in the press. Say that my own people disown me. And the best way back is to keep
their... What differences do you notice between shortboarding and longboarding? Riding the boards.
Different size waves, deeper waves for short boards.
Oh, I mean, how do you think they handle? Like, how do they handle?
Shortboard's much easier to handle. It's to turn. Longboards are much harder to turn.
Do you think a shortboarder or a longboard can be stereotyped at all?
Stereotypes, sure, they are all the time.
How are the stereotypes?
Because you're more aggressive people on shortboards and more calm people are on longboards.
We'll be right back.